So this is a poem about suffering from chronic and pathological niceness. I don't know if any of you all are afflicted with that, but I certainly am. Do you remember your parents' favorite story about you when you were a child? Mine was this. They could lock me in a closet full of precious china, tell me not to touch it, and hours later return the china untouched. I was a good girl. Girls are sugar and spice and everything nice. When that gym teacher with steel eyes boring through greasy horn-rimmed glasses asks you to stay after school so he can test your arm strength using your cone-shaped breasts to lift you to the monkey bars, don't walk straight home. Do what you're told. Good girls do what they're told. When that guy from Match.com refuses to take you to dinner, but is gracious enough to invite you to his wealthy aunt's empty house to hang out between his thighs, always say yes. Nice girls say yes when they're asked to do favors. When that curmudgeon sharing a smoke break with you outside the conference in North Carolina says, "It's shame about Hitler. That guy had some good ideas." Maintain your diplomatic silence. Respect your elders. When that friend bludgeons the heart and brains of your most tender, raw poem and dismembers the words you didn't dare speak, briefly apologize for your truth and for making him witness your incorrigible guts and say, "Wow, thank you for the feedback. That's really helpful." It's only the courteous thing to do. Remember, only write nice poems. Poems that are forgiveness and serenity and inspiration and elevation of spirit and God and dragonflies. Poems that would make Rumi proud. Keep your jaw clenched and claw at your own skin until you frighten all the screaming away and it retreats like a silent, deadly eel slipping back into a coral reef. Girls are sugar and spice and everything nice. Thank you.